Hey, I just got back in the truck. I just shot some drone footage of a property here in Texas. And I was down here this morning and spent several hours on a piece of property with Brandon White. Brandon is a forester and a real estate broker, and he's one of my top guys here in Texas. And we were looking at a pretty good sized tract this morning. And I, just to be honest with you, it is a butchered mess as far as the timber goes. And I was telling Brandon, I go, man, why in the world would somebody allow this to happen on their place? I mean, there's too many good guys like you that know how to manage a place like this and cut the timber and leave it where it can be profitable and beneficial going forward. And he goes, man, I don't know. Just people do that. And so my two cents is, if you've got timberland, get a good forester to manage it for you. I don't have a dog in that hunt. I don't make anything out of it by telling you to do that, other than, you know, I want you to have the best piece of property you can have. And if you've got timberland and you want to maximize the income and you want to leave it for your family going forward, or maybe sell it out in the distant future, don't be so short-sighted that you go in there and just slash and burn today for every little dollar, and then you leave nothing going forward, and it's going to cost you in the long run. I mean, I don't know. I'm not a forester, but I've got a little bit of sense when it comes to timber management, because I've got a lot of great foresters on my team. I mean, Brandon White, Scott Nevins up in Northeast Texas, Bobby Fuchs over in the Nacogdoches area, Chris Bordelon in Shreveport, Nathan Rennick in Mississippi, Coy Perkey. I mean, I've got some top guys, and I listen to them. I pay attention when they're talking timber management. Some friends of mine, Rocky Burke, you probably know him in Monroe. Merlin Smith, fine gentleman, a second generation forestry business there in Monroe. Heck, Merlin's forgotten more about timber management than I'll ever know. But when these guys are talking, I'm listening, and I've learned just a little bit about timber management, enough to know that when I get on a track like this, I go, dang, Brandon, this is a butchered mess. That's my way of saying it. Brandon, who is a certified forester, been doing it for a living for a long time, just looks at me and goes, you're exactly right. So, it's just obvious when it's there. So, my two cents, if you got timberland, whether it's a small track or huge tracks, Let a professional manage it for you. You'll be money ahead if you do. The foresters that we use, and I've got a little knowledge about timber management and logging and things like that, but I still call one of my guys when we want to manage timber or cut timber, and I pay them. I pay them what anybody else would pay them, because I come out money ahead by letting a pro take care of my timber. And I encourage you to do the same. Just for what it's worth, had it on my mind since we looked at this place this morning. Don't let your place end up like this place. So, bye.